Hey, what's up everybody? My name is Y4Y4 and welcome back to another Comet Arms video. Now first off, I'd like to thank you guys so much for watching my channel and subscribing, because I do really appreciate it. I just hit 2 million views. I just can't believe that that number just so big. It's so big. I'm just kidding. I never even expected to hit 1 million views, so I just appreciate all what you guys have done for me. And made YouTube so fun for me to do. But without further ado, let's get into this Comet Arms video. So the gameplay you're watching is from a Dredge game that I played, and I just noticed that after a couple of games, I was in this game, and I just, felt kind of back like the old days of CA. I felt into it, I felt like I knew what I was doing, and I was just doing really well this gameplay. So you may be wondering, how'd you choose this? How'd you know to record? Stuff like that. I'm always recording whenever I'm playing Comet Arms. It's just the question whether or not I actually use that footage in a video. I'm always recording. Sometimes I rage and just quit playing Comet Arms for the day. Sometimes I get really good clips. Like this one. I actually really like this one. So I was playing on Dredge and I just noticed, man, my score is doing really well, and then all of a sudden I was just thinking of what was I doing to make my score so good, and I don't know, I just kind of totally felt in sync with the game for once, actually, because normally when I play Comet Arms I just feel a little awkward. Ever since I changed my crouch button to control, it just has always felt a little weird playing it, because I used to have crouch on right click, so sometimes I'll accidentally scope in. I think you might even be able to see this on this video at one point. I'm not sure. It just happens every once in a while. It's hard to make the switch for buttons, but I just figured it would be better in general to have a crouch not on the mouse, just because it kind of ruins it for other games as well, like CSGO especially. But back to the point of the video. So I titled this video something along the lines of awareness, or awareness in Comet Arms, because I realized as I was playing this match that there's some things that I've never told you guys about what goes on in my mind when I play Comet Arms. And I'm sure I've mentioned some of these things, but a lot of them, well, there's not a lot, but I don't know. I just feel like it's worth revisiting if I've already mentioned some of these, and it's worth also mentioning these new things that I figured out in my mind of playing, just kind of gonna say it out loud. So the first thing I'd like to say, and I know I've talked about this before, is being aware of sound. So you may think, oh yeah, I'm wearing headphones, I can hear where people are, etc., etc. Well, this is not the sound I'm talking about. While this is important, and this is what I've been talking about before, sound footsteps, that's important, but there's abilities to cancel that, so it's really hard to rely on that nowadays. But just sound where people are, I've already talked about that, but I just realized that I listen to weapon sounds as well. And it might be a lot of work to do it at first, but if you listen to weapon sounds, you can make things happen so much easier. And what I mean by listening to weapon sounds. So when you hear a certain weapon go off, if you've played the game enough, you're going to know which weapon that was. And then from here, you know where somebody is with that weapon. And I just put two and two together, and I do this kind of in the background without even noticing. But I'll listen to what weapons go off, and then I'll go up in the left corner of my screen and look at the kill feed and just check and see what weapon just killed somebody. So if I hear a Mac 10 go off and then I look at the kill feed and I see that it's a blue, my teammate killed somebody, then I don't have to worry. But if I hear a dual scorpions go off and I look up and I see that's in red, then I know that there's an enemy right by me with the dual scorpions. So I don't know, it's just another kind of thing to look at, and it helps so much because then you don't have to worry about other people coming near you. Or if you're on an unbelievable streak or something, then you're going to know exactly where somebody is, because gunshots are really easily, I said that really weird. Gunshots are one of the easiest way to find somebody in Comet Arms for sound wise. So if you know that's an enemy, by looking up at the kill feed, hearing the weapon that's being shot and seeing that it's an enemy, just go to the sound and he'll probably be low health because he just fought somebody. So, next tip, be aware of glimpses of people. So, I don't know if I've ever really talked about this. Obviously, you're like, why for? Oh, dude, it's obvious. If you see a person, obviously. But I'm talking you see some little thing move in the corner of your eye. Comet Arms doesn't have much moving things in the map, no animals or anything. There's a few moving machines and stuff like that. but there's generally not much movement except for players. So if you see any sort of movement at all, that's definitely going to be a player, practically, pretty much. And if they don't have a name tag, then you know that it's not a teammate. So you can straight up just go get a kill. So go find that out. I use that a lot. I was using that. I've always used this. I just never thought to share it because it was so obvious. But if you see just one little thing move, you can tell that's an enemy, even if it's in the corner of your screen in your peripherals. The next thing I'd like to talk about is be aware of which weapon will work best in each scenario. So in this video, I used a G36 and a UMP45, and I think that's a good combination, especially for this map, because the G36 can reach all the way across the map, and the UMP45 is a fairly accurate submachine gun and fairly powerful as well. So this might be pretty obvious. Be aware of what weapon will work best in the scenario, but I always see people trying to fight me close up with like some slow assault rifle or something. I mean, don't get me wrong, that's fine. But it'll be a lot easier to kill somebody if you have a submachine gun if you're really close to them. So you can just see in the video that I just am constantly switching between weapons. You can see, I think, when I'm in like the middle area of the map, I always switch to the UMP because there's no point in keeping out the G36. You just kind of got to think in the back of your mind, what weapon's going to be best for if somebody's right around the corner? Something like that. You got to just think about that. Now the final thing that I would like to bring up is be aware of the bullets in your clip, and I've talked about this many times, but I just figured I'd reiterate it because we're on the topic of awareness, and these are all just things that I wrote down what I saw in my gameplay after playing that and recording it after feeling really good. I played this actually a couple days ago, so this is a couple days old and I've had time to think about it, but just always be aware of how many bullets are in your clip. It's a really obvious thing and it's really easy to check. It's sometimes hard to see while you're fighting somebody, but just try and get a quick glimpse, because if you know you're about to run out of bullets, then you have to switch to your next weapon. Or, I mean, you can reload, but you'll probably die if you're fighting with somebody else that has an automatic weapon as well. So those were just kind of my general awareness tips. I thought the first one was a really interesting thing. I never really thought about it to say it out loud, never really thought that I was doing that, but I was. But yeah, that's just what I have for you guys today. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Be sure to like the video, and I will see you guys later. Peace out. I hope you guys enjoyed the gameplay.